Hello students of class 9. So today I am going to start the new topic. Already I have discussed the two exercises of lines and angles. So today we will start one theorem. We will do one theorem, proof of one theorem. Okay. So the theorem is what? Angle sum property of a triangle. So what do you mean by angle sum property of a triangle? That means if we add all the angles, okay, that means the sum of all the angles of a triangle should be equal to 180 degree. Okay. So let us read the theorem first. So theorem is the sum of the angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So first of all, you have to draw a triangle. So I have drawn a triangle and I have marked the vertex as P, Q and R. So next, first of all, we have to write the given conditions. So what is given here? Only a triangle is given and we have named it PQR. So we have to write PQR as a triangle. Next, what we have to prove? We have to prove that all the three angles, that means angle B plus angle Q plus angle R, is equal to 180 degree. Next, how to prove it? For proving it, we have to do some construction. Okay, so what construction we will do? See here. Draw a line XPY parallel to QR. So here we are drawing a line through P so that it is parallel to what? Parallel to QR. That means this line is parallel to QR. And the line which we have drawn, we have to mark the line. So here I am giving it a name. So the name is XPY. Okay, so XPY is parallel to QR and we have drawn this line through the point P. Okay, so now we can start our proof, but before proving, let us mark the angles. Okay, so here there are total 5 angles present, so we will mark these angles. So first of all, I am marking angle P as angle 1, this angle I am marking it as 2 and this angle I am marking it as 3. Okay, so like that only, this angle I am marking it as 4 and this one as 5. So now we will start the proof. So see, in the proof first what I have written, from diagram we are writing it. So from diagram we can see that XPY is a straight line. So straight line makes angle how much? 180 degree. So we can write angle 4 plus angle 1 plus 5 is equal to 180 degree. So the first line is angle 4 plus angle 1 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degree. Since XPY is a straight line, so straight line, that means straight angle, it forms angle is equal to 180 degree. Okay. So next, but XPY, that means the straight line XPY, is parallel to what? QR. It is parallel to QR. So if it is parallel to QR, then there will be alternate angles, okay, alternate angles which are equal. So now we have to see the alternate angles. See, XPY is parallel to QR and PQ and PR are transversal. See, these two lines, this is XPY and this is QR. And here only PQ is like that, okay. So that means PQ is what? PQ is a transversal. Similarly, another line is PR, it is like that. So this is also a transversal. Okay, so these are the two transversal for these parallel lines, XPY and QR. Okay, so if transversal is there, parallel line is there, then we can mark or we can write the alternate pair of alternate angles. So see, here the angle is 4 and here the angle is, this one is 2. So that means angle 4 is equal to angle 2. Similarly here, you can see this angle is 5, this one, and this angle is what? 3. That means they are also equal. They are pair of alternate angles. And we know when there are parallel lines and transversal intersects the parallel line, the alternate angles are what? Equal. Okay. So here angle 4 will be equal to angle 2 and angle 5 will be equal to angle 3. So in bracket you have to write the reason that pair of alternate angles. These are pair of alternate angles. Now what we will do? See here, this is angle 4. Angle 4. The value of angle 4 is angle 2 and the value of angle 5 is equal to angle 3. So these value we can substitute in equation 1. This first one we have marked it as equation number 1. So now we can put the value of angle 4 as angle 2 here. Angle 2. Similarly, in place of angle 5, we can write what? We can write angle 3. Okay, so that is the next thing which I have written. Substituting angle 4 and angle 5 in equation 1, we get angle 2. In place of angle 4, we can write angle 2. Plus angle 1 will be same. Plus in place of angle 5, this is angle 3. So angle 2 plus angle 1 plus angle 3 is equal to 180 degree. That is nothing but angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 is equal to 180 degree. That is the same thing. Okay. We can write this in this form. You know about commutative property. Here we are using the commutative property. Okay. We can add the numbers in any order. The answer will remains same. Okay. So angle 1 is what? Angle 1 is P. This one is angle P. We have marked it. Next angle 2 is what? Angle Q. And next angle 3 is what? Angle R. That is equal to 180 degree. That was the proof of this question. So we have to prove it. So we have proved it. That means we can write, hence the theorem is proved. So this theorem you can use in your question part. Okay, when you will do the questions of triangles, okay, then you can use this theorem. So next theorem is theorem 6.8. In this theorem, it is written that if a side of a triangle, if a side of a triangle is produced, then the exterior angle so formed is equal to the sum of the two interior opposite angles. That means what is happening here? We are extending a side of a triangle. So suppose this side, this is a triangle PQR, and I am extending one of its sides. So I have taken one side. So that side is QR. You can take any side, but here I am taking QR as a side. Okay, that side I am extending. So I am extending side QR up to M, so that the exterior angle which is formed here. So exterior angle is angle 4. Okay, exterior means outside the triangle. So this angle is equal to sum. Okay, this exterior angle is equal to the sum of two interior opposite angles. Interior opposite. Interior means inside, and the meaning of opposite is angle 4, opposite of angle 4. See here, angle 3 is not opposite of angle 4. Angle 3 is adjacent of angle 4. Okay. So what are the opposite angles of 4? This will be what? 1 and 2. Angle 1 and 2 will be opposite to what? Angle 4. So we can write, according to the statement, we can write the exterior angle will be equal to the sum of, that means we have to add the two interior opposite angle. And the two interior opposite angle, that means inside the triangle, is we have 1 and 2, and it is opposite of 4. Okay. So according to this theorem, we have to prove this one. So how to prove this? Just I am giving you some points, some hints. You have to use that points and you have to prove the theorem. Okay. So what you have to do? First of all, you know, by angle sum property, you know that angle 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equal to 180 degree. This will be the first equation. And next, you know that angle 3 plus angle 4 is also equal to 180 degree, because they form linear pair of angles. Angle 3 plus angle 4, because when we add the two angles, we will get a straight line. Okay. So by adding these two angles, we will get a straight line. That's why it forms what? Linear pair. Already I discussed about linear pair. So by that way, you will get two equations. The first equation will be this one, and the second equation will be this one. Okay. So what we have to do from these two equations? See, the sum of these is equal to 180 degree, and sum of these two angles is also equal to 180 degree. That means we can equate these two. Okay. We can equate these two. You see, if x is equal to, suppose, 3 and y is equal to also 3, then what will happen? We can write x is equal to y. Okay. Similarly here, we can write this is equal to this. So if we write this is equal to this, then angle 3 will get cancelled and finally you will get angle 4 is equal to angle 1 plus 2. Okay, this is the proof of this theorem. So try to do the proof. So I am starting the questions now from exercise 6.3. So I am doing question number 2. See what is given in this question. Given angle x is equal to 62 degree. Okay, next is angle xyz and this is the full angle y. Okay, so we can write y also. So angle xyz is equal to 54. That means this whole angle is 54 degree. So try to concentrate on the big triangle. That means on the big triangle angle in triangle xyz. Okay, in this big triangle what is given? This angle is given, that is angle x, and angle y is given. Okay, z is not given, this is not given. Okay, so next what is given? Further see what is given. Y, O and Z O are bisector of angle XYZ and XZY of triangle X of triangle XYZ. So YO, this is YO and this is ZO. These are the bisector of angle Y and angle Z respectively. So what happen? What bisectors do? Bisector bisects the angle. Okay, this is an angle bisector. So angle bisector bisects the angle into two equal parts. So if the full angle is 54 degree, then these two angles, that means this angle and this angle, will be half of what? 54 degree, that will be 27 degree. Okay, but we cannot write like this. We have to simplify it. We have to show it. We have to show the calculation. And calculation you can easily do. Half of 54 degree will be what? 27 degree. Okay, so we will do it in the solution part. So see, these are bisector. Okay, these are bisector. That means YO and ZO are the bisector. So see, this full angle Z, we don't know what is the value of this angle Z. So first of all, we will find the value of angle Z. And then next, we will find the half of angle Y and half of angle Z. By that way, we can easily find the angle from this small triangle. That is a triangle OYZ. From triangle OYZ, we can easily find this angle and this angle. Because this angle will be the half of this full angle, that is 54 degree. And this angle will be the half of this angle Z. Okay. So this is we have to find. Okay. This one we have to find, this angle. Now see the solution. First of all, I have taken the big triangle. So this triangle I have taken. So see, the triangle like is like this. So first of all, we have taken this triangle. In this is 62 degree and this is 54 degree. Z is not given. So by angle sum property, we can write sum of all angles is 180 degree. So by that way, we can find the value of Z. It is 64 degree. Okay. So this is very simple. You can easily simplify it. Next, see what I have taken. I have taken the smaller one, the smaller triangle. In smaller triangle, see this one, that is angle OYZ. Okay. This angle OYZ, that is I have written angle OYZ, that means this angle, okay. This angle is equal to half of angle Y because it is already given that they are the bisectors. So, and angle OZY, angle OZY means this angle, okay. This is half of what? That angle Z. Also in place of angle Z, you can write angle XZY, okay. So, next. Half of angle Y, so angle Y already given, it is the full angle already given 54 degree, so we can write 54 degree. Similarly, half of in place of angle Z, we can write 64 degree, already we have found that one. So this will be 32 degree, that means this angle is 32 degree and this small angle what we found, this one is 27 degree. Okay, so this is the solution of this question. If they asked to find the angle O, that means this angle. So this angle also you can find easily. How to find? See, as you see, triangle OYZ makes a full triangle. Okay, triangle OYZ. OYZ makes a triangle. That means angle O plus 27 degree plus 32 degree will be what? 180 degree by angle sum property. So by that way, we can also find the value of angle O. Okay. So this much for today. Please try to practice. Okay. So thank you.